think you should. I'm not gonna upload this video later or anything, but that doesn't mean I'm not gonna keep this video short. And that's essentially just because of the fact that Boruto episode 42 was not a very eventful episode. If anything, it was a very boring episode. I talked about last week about what they could do and what they couldn't do, and that would essentially give us something enticing and exciting to watch and keep us interested, or they can give us something completely boring and super filler, and I'm just very bored watching through it. And that's why, that's exactly what happened. I was really bored beginning to end of the episode. The beginning of the episode starts off kind of like how part one kind of did with like a couple of its episodes, mainly the filler episodes, but basically Boruto, Sarada, and Mitsuki are doing a mission where they need to find a lost cat, they return it. Boruto goes to this like shop or whatever, and he buys a game that just came out, a video game that just came out, right, on the day of, obviously, the events that happened take place in the episode. I made a joke to myself, I was like, oh, is it Dragon Ball Fighters? Because that game's coming out in a couple of days. So, the whole time, Boruto's like, oh, I want a higher rank mission, but of course that can happen because if it happened a few years ago, during like part one, and even Shippuden, then it's like, Boruto would be getting a lot more like higher rank, kind of like ish missions, a lot more dangerous missions, but because it's a time of peace, that doesn't exactly happen, and missions like that are extremely rare. So, if it's gonna be like that, there's almost no point of even having any sort of like filler episode, because it's all gonna be just straight boring, and I don't understand why the writers are just going straight into the Boruto movie episodic episodes, because at least that would be more eventful and exciting than what we're getting right now. So the whole time he's talking about like, oh, I hate how I'm not getting acknowledgement for doing the mission, blah 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 blah. I don't know what he's talking about either way. Then they get a mission. Bank robber is holding himself in there. There's a bomb strapped on his chest. No one's in there. He's a complete amateur. He doesn't know exactly what he's even doing in the first place. Boruto goes in there. He talks to him. He talks him out of doing it. Apparently the guy worked on the game that Boruto got like earlier in the episode. Apparently he also got fired because apparently someone said something about him leaking out like information about his company, and that got him fired, and a whole bunch of other companies wouldn't hire him because of that reason, because they overheard it. Overall, Boruto didn't even need to worry about the guy, because by the end of the episode, after, you know, the police like caught him because reasons, right? It's because Boruto is gonna be able to talk Nojutsu him out of it every single time. Essentially, the bomb wasn't even lethal. It probably wasn't even going to even work anyways. It wasn't fatal. So even then, there was no danger whatsoever. This guy was a complete amateur and a pushover. The only, you know, positive thing he has in his life is he created a video game that Boruto really liked. Two of them, in fact. Or rather, mainly one, and then he made a sequel. So whatever, right? That's the biggest positive in his life. And that was actually the reason why the guy actually surrendered himself, because it's like, because he felt the same way that Boruto did earlier in the beginning, and then Boruto was like, alright, I actually like your game, I like the first one, I put a whole bunch of hours into it, I thought it was dope, and I want to do the exact same thing on the sequel, even though sequels always suck for stupid reasons. So the episode ends. Apparently the guy was about to kill himself. He was about to jump in front of a train, but then some guy showed up and then like talked him out of it, and then was like, yo, if you go to this place on this time and this like kind of area, I guess, or whatever, you're gonna be able to like hold up a bank and get like money or something like that. I don't know, but like apparently it leads up to the plot of the next episode where there's a gang, and they're called the Byakuya gang. Not Byakugan, but Byakuya, like kind of like Byakuya from Bleach. If you watch Bleach, of course. So I don't know. It wasn't eventful. It wasn't an eventful episode. It was very boring. I was bored watching the rest of the episode. It just wasn't interesting. I was just like, can it just end already? I'm the episode. The whole Byakuya gang thing. At the end of the previews, one of them used like kind of like ice release, and now they belong to the Yuki clan back in part one, and they don't exist anymore because they all died. So I don't know what that is, but whatever. So that's the end of the video. I said I was gonna keep it short, and I meant that literally. I don't even know how long I've been recording for. Probably nothing more than 5 minutes, but anyways, I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, please sure to leave a like. If you're new to the channel, please consider hitting the subscribe button and turn on the notification button so you don't miss a new video. I'll see you guys in the next one, and I'm out.